The world is full of noise, and all too often, that noise attempts to drown out the message of hope that moms so desperately need to hear.
It is our calling to help you reach this level of freedom, to understand who you were created to be, and to walk fully in your purpose. From daily routines to slaying giants, we're going to talk about things that matter, help you find a balance that works for you, and tackle mindsets that hold you back.
We craft each episode to speak to a specific challenge in motherhood, leaving you feeling inspired and equipped with tools to make changes that will propel you on the path to your calling. We are about purpose, identity, and freedom. I'm Dr. Bayless.
And I'm Jackie Bailey, and this is Point of Decision.
Welcome to Point of Decision. We're so glad that you're here with us today. We have a special, special guest who's really dear to my heart, who I just love and look up to so much. She is a wife, and not just a wife. She's married to famous TikTok Tom. Go look him up. He's so fun. Oh my goodness. Love him. She's a mom of four beautiful girls, including a set of twins. She's a public speaker, a top entrepreneur. She's actually the top earner in Savvy Fitness Wear. Also, she and her family have become social media celebrities. Her video, Hot Mom Check, made them go viral. So look it up because she's just absolutely beautiful. So Kim and her husband, Tom, also have a coaching business. They coach people in how to be successful in the entrepreneurial space, the MLM space. They also hold conferences and love to pour into people on a very deep level. We just love Kim, and we're super excited to just hear some of her story and how she's made it to the top and impacted the world. So welcome, Kim.
Welcome.
So glad you're here.
Oh my goodness. Well, thank you so very much. I'm so honored and grateful to be here and really share my story. And yeah. I just thank you so much for that crazy, amazing introduction, Jackie.
So tell us a little bit about your personal fitness story, how, and also how your family has played a role in it, and how you've just overcome so many obstacles in your life.
Just speaking specifically on my health and fitness journey. Oh my goodness, super passionate about this because it's something that I think so many women struggle with in their self-image and in really their identity.
Yes.
And how much the enemy gets in there and lies to us about this area. Yeah. I know he personally did with me for many, many, many years.
Yeah.
And that the thing is, like, I struggled with low confidence in my self-image before there was even social media and Instagram.
Wow.
And so I look at how it impacts our younger generation, how it impacts us as moms, how it impacts everybody to, like, try to live up to this world that feels like kind of everybody looks perfect out there,
right?
But I'm not.
That's tough. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I'd love to share my personal story.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit vulnerable to talk about this because I'll preface this whole thing by saying I have a beautiful relationship with my mom and dad. Beautiful. Yeah. But there were some things that happened to me growing up, or some words spoken, I guess, over me that really impacted my journey in health.
Right.
And it really had to do with the relationship my father and my mother had with each other. My mom, having two daughters, I grew up in a family where my mom was obese, my sister, my entire family. Actually, I came from a family of obesity. And I knew deep down something in me very early on that I wanted to not go that route in my life. Like, I wanted to be fit.
Right.
Whatever that looked like growing up, I didn't know, but I just knew I didn't want to go down that road because I saw my mom diet her entire life, but never lose the weight.
Right.
And so it was really confusing for me. And she used to say to me all the time, you know, I had this really cute figure my whole life until I had kids.
Oh my gosh.
And she didn't know what she was doing. Maybe she was justifying, you know, why she was overweight, but I took it like, oh my goodness, if I have kids, I'm going to get overweight.
Right.
And I'm terrified now to have kids. Like, that's kind of what it built in me over the years. But then later on, my parents actually divorced, and I had a lot of talks with my dad. And the words he kept saying is that, you know, I just fell out of love with your mom, and I just wasn't attracted to her. Oh, and if there's one thing you do in your life, make sure you always stay attractive for your spouse.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
That's so much pressure.
And he didn't. He was trying to give me sound advice that it really is, to a degree, important to be attractive for our spouses.
Wow.
But when you're young and you don't know how to process that, I processed it like, oh my goodness, number one, if I have kids, I'm going to gain weight.
Right.
And if I gain weight, my husband is going to fall out of love with me, and I could end up in a divorce. Like, that was the fear and the lie of the enemy that I went down.
Yeah.
That would be so much pressure for anyone.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
It almost sounded like, you know, when your mom told you as a child, she had this cute figure until she had kids, like she was almost blaming it on you guys. That plays a really serious, detrimental role on your psyche. It's probably subconsciously played a role in your subconscious.
That's what it's I felt when you said it.
Yeah, that's what I felt when you said it. Like,
Wow. You guys, I had never thought about that my entire life.
Yeah.
Never.
Yeah.
Like, it probably did.
That's what I felt in my spirit totally when you said it.
Wow. Even if it wasn't intentional.
Yeah.
Now, here I am having a breakthrough doing this podcast.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
so
you,
good.
Jesus. Yes.
Yeah.
Truly. Wow. I'm going to hold on to that.
Yeah.
So what happened with that was that I ended up knowing that I have to be thin, right?
Right.
I didn't know how. I had zero education on how to do it. And so I tried to use my own logic and go, okay, if I eat fat, that will make me fat.
Right.
And I don't like eating meat, really. Mm-hmm. And so I'm just going to eat carbs, because you can eat a whole bowl of popcorn and it's hardly any calories.
Right.
Wow. And I would purge on carbs till I was sick and I would throw up.
Mm.
And that was the road I started to go down. I was obsessed with the scale. I got on it 15 times a day. If my stomach was a little purging out, I would do a million sit-ups. I mean, I just, it was so vain. It was so vain, and it was just so wrong. And it wasn't till I actually was in a seminar, Jackie, that you and I were both in, and we know who this was.
Yeah.
But fast forward, I do all this unhealthy stuff.
Oh my goodness.
And I know I'm super unhealthy because I was eating carbs, and carbs convert to sugar. And here I am gaining weight. And I actually joined a gym, and they took my body fat composition. And according to the charts, I was 33% body fat, which for my height was putting me on the road to obesity. Like, I was right on the verge.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Then I went the opposite direction and just started, you know, doing the purging and throwing up. And I got so thin. I was about 90 pounds. I lost my period. So here I was bouncing around, so lost, not knowing what to do, just totally obsessed with my body. And I'm not even married yet.
Right.
Well, I'm going to fast forward, because here I am. I get married and terrified to have kids. But here I am, 4 kids in 3.5 years.
Wow.
And we got married, and my husband does things fast. So here we were within a year of marriage. I was pregnant, and then it just was a snowball until we figured out, okay, we better stop this, or we know where this is heading. And now I'm even more terrified. I look at myself in the mirror, and here I am. My body is just not itself. I had twins. I had back-to-back pregnancies. I feel disgusted, felt my whole identity was wrapped up in how I looked. And I was terrified, crying, look at myself crying. It was, it's such a mind battle what women go through.
Yeah,
it really is.
And it wasn't until I ended up in a seminar, and I gave it all to the Lord, and I was struggling so much, but just tears rolling down my face. I can get emotional now. In a heartbeat, freed me of the vanity that I was stuck in, the stronghold that I was stuck in, that was making me put my whole world wrapped up into. I was so insecure. I was so insecure. He freed me in a heartbeat. Wow. So I know the power of God. And when you truly surrender an area in your life to him, what he can do with that. And I can tell you, with everything in me from this day forward, I have never, never struggled with my weight. Don't even own a scale. none of that. It's just Hallelujah. Freedom. Freedom from that. Now, Amen. I did go through a path of education. And now, what, God, how am I supposed to eat? What am I supposed to do?
Right.
So, sorry, That's
don't okay. be, please.
Yeah. Please so don't good. Be sorry at all. The tears are real. So we just appreciate your vulnerability and we appreciate exposing the truth. The whole part of your story that resonated so much and just was so, so impactful was how you were delivered from that in an instant
yes.
by the Lord.
So good.
And Jesus yeah. is totally responsible for that. And you could just give it all to him at the foot of the cross. I just think of all of those who don't know Jesus on a personal level and mm-hmm. how much he can just take all that pain and all that sorrow and all of that fear and anxiety away in an instant.
Amen.
I just love that story. And I really think that there's something very deep that goes into the psyche when you have a parent who is obese and you either follow that and you make those excuses like, oh, it's genetic.
Yes.
Our whole family just suffers from obesity. It's just something in our genes, but it's really not. It's choices that are made. And you could be big boned. Like, I'm actually big boned as a woman, but I'm not obese.
Yes.
You know, I could have used that as an excuse because my mother did crash diets too. My whole childhood, she was on diets. She would lose the weight and then she'd gain it all back and more. And I never used that as an excuse. But I can relate to your story and it's really beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And I just want to touch on what you said, because I think so many people do say that. In fact, I've been judged, you know, I'm 48 years old. I have four kids. I'm in pretty good fitness
You're
shape.
In phenomenal shape. Just, I know you can't say it yourself, but I'll say it for you. You are in phenomenal shape, but I've seen you, Kim, and you don't strive for it. You
no.
rest in it and
yes.
you still treat yourself. You know, you don't binge and you don't purge at all, like ever that I've seen. Like, you'll let yourself have a little treat, but it's just a little one, you know? It's
100%. Yeah. I do all the time. And
yeah.
I do have a little hack for that.
Awesome. I can't wait to hear it.
But, you know, and I heard all the time, oh, you must have good genes. Everything
right.
you're saying, oh, you must have good genes. And I just want to say, no, I mean, I know that there's this genetic myth out there, but you truly have the power to not walk that out.
Right.
And all it is education. All it is learning what should you do? How do you feed your body? How
right.
do you treat this one body that God's given you, this one body? How does he want you to treat it?
Yeah.
And when you get that and you learn, it's just a lifestyle that you can embrace, that you have the power to shift or change any trajectory that you feel you might have been born with.
Right.
You can totally do it no matter what.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's so encouraging.
Yeah.
Especially after having four kids. Amazing.
Thank you.
We've all had four kids. Leslie has two.
I do have four kids.
Amazing.
Yes.
You have two little kids.
Right.
You have two little ones. That's busy.
Yes.
I do. I have two. I have one adult, one teenager, and two babies.
Amazing. I'm in that my gray hairs are coming in faster and faster because mine are all in the upper teens and one just turned 21 and they
oh,
all
yeah.
have boyfriends and three learn to drive all at the same time.
Oh,
and it's craziness.
Yes. I have one learning to drive now. It's yes.
You can relate.
Yeah.
What kind of mindset issues did you overcome to get to where you are? You know, I know that the Holy Spirit just delivered you and then he started working on your mind. What are some of the things that you implemented that worked for you?
Yeah, I'd even love to share that story of my journey with learning how amazing this God is. I think it just in that moment of being totally free, he just empowered me, gave me the hunger to want to learn. Like, the lies were just broken away in a heartbeat. And in this one area, now I struggled in other areas of other mindset. I mean, I battled fear my entire life. I've tried to trace it back. Like, where did I pick up the crazy belief system that I have of this one area of my life? Who knows? You never know, like what you just said, Jackie, of what's spoken over you and how
yeah.
you carry that forward in your life. I want to share part of my story that shifted the whole trajectory of my life. That was when I was saved as a young girl. I grew up in a Christian home and I knew him very early, but when my parents went through that divorce, that struggle, it kind of sent me off into this tailspin. I ended up dating everyone I shouldn't date. I was partying, I was drinking, I was dallying in drugs. And that was really the same season where I was trying to figure out how to be thin and all that stuff, all the things the enemy really was working in my life at this time. And I had a moment. It's amazing how God meets you where you're at. Because
right.
I woke up one day just going, who am I? And I was in the shower just crying and saying, God, I know this isn't me. Please help me, like save me. And I was just lost.
Yeah. Wow.
I went in, no joke, within a week of that prayer, I had reached my level of, if I die in this moment, I don't know if I'm going to heaven. Mm. Like that was the fear.
Yeah.
And I walked in to get a perm, and back in the day, we actually did perms. We don't do them anymore. And the woman who's doing my hair, total woman of God, she could sense in her spirit, and she kept asking me questions, and she could tell I was going down the wrong path. Mm-hmm. And in the moment, she goes, Kim, can you follow me in the back here real quick? And I do. And she goes, God's telling me to pray for you right now.
Wow.
And literally, I just started crying, just bawling. Mm-hmm. We got on our knees. And she basically led me in a prayer that where I rededicated my life to the Lord.
Wow.
And it was powerful. And I'd love to say in that moment, like I walked out a new person, but I had one foot in the world and one foot back in my roots of knowing my true identity.
Right.
And so I battled this double life for a good year after that.
Mm.
And until I had my real defining my God moment where I knew he was after me.
Right.
If he didn't show me in the salon, I just graduated college and I was selling my college car and I thought I was invincible. I'm driving 85 miles an hour down the freeway and rushing to get here. And I looked up and I was just inches from hitting a car.
Oh,
and so I overcorrected. I started spinning on a freeway where there were five lanes of traffic and I spun at about 85 miles an hour off the freeway.
Oh my goodness.
And I hit a pole. So many miracles happened. But I forgot the most important part. As I was spinning out of control, saying, I'm going to die.
Yeah.
The number one thing that came to me was to scream the name of Jesus. And I did at the top of my lungs. I said, Jesus. And then all these miracles happened. I hit a pole, which slowed me down. I hit the only part of the freeway where there was a curb, which my tires hit at the same time, buckled under the car, and I slid down a dirt embankment, 30-foot embankment, down a hill.
Oh my
and I
gosh.
Never rolled. I never, like it, God saved my life in that moment.
Wow.
But that was my aha moment of like, I need to get my life back on track because that was a life or death. Like I should not have survived that.
Yes.
So I just want you to know like God is after our hearts in the biggest way. And he's so patient with us and he loves us so much and he meets us where we're at. And you know, for me, I had to have that wake up moment.
Yeah.
But I pray most people don't have to have that kind of a moment because it's super scary.
Yeah.
That totally got me on the path of really getting me to where I am today, really knowing who this God is.
Right. Wow. Yes. I'm sitting over here in tears because I just couldn't imagine.
I realized I wasn't breathing. Take a breath.
Yeah.
We have like so much. God wants to do something with us,
yes.
right? We have this purpose. We're all born for a purpose.
Yes.
And there's a very real enemy that wants to kill, steal and destroy. He'll do it through your identity, through the lies. He'll rob your joy. He'll, you know, and there's just, we have to realize that we truly are born to make an impact and to change lives.
Yeah.
Yes.
For me, I love to share it because I was so crippled in fear that I had a really another aha moment. I ran from fear more than I can tell you in my lifetime. I just had zero self-confidence. It's crazy. And like I said, I tried to trace that back. Where did I pick up this thought that I'm not good enough, that I don't have a voice, that people to fear people and what they think of me? Like, where did I pick all that up? And I realized that as I was going through life, I had all these opportunities that I ran away from. They scared me to death.
Right.
And I had zero belief that I could do it. So that was the next piece of my life, was really learning how to overcome all these fears and these lies and this negative reel that we all do, by the way. We all do it. We have like 80,000 thoughts or 50,000 thoughts. I forget what it is. It's a lot of thoughts every single day.
Wow.
And 80% of those are negative. Mm. And of those 80%, 95 of those are on autopilot, just like it's an instant reflex.
Wow.
I was at a point where God kept calling me out of that, but I was too fearful. And I had a moment, my husband plays a big role in this because we started doing seminars and he's like, Kim, so many people battle with fear. You need to talk on fear.
Yeah.
And I'm in the whole midst of the fear thing. And I'm like, babe, there's no way, I'm too afraid.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yep. Right.
And he goes, Kim, get over it. You're supposed to do it.
Amen.
Amen. Right?
Everybody needs a little good kick in the pants.
Yes. Leave it to yes. A challenger husband to just push you. I remember that conference because I was there.
You were there.
Awesome.
And I was terrified. I was shaking. Yes. I was fried before and after, and probably during. Oh my gosh. It was one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. And thank God for spouses that do that, that yes. really see who we are and call us out.
Yes.
Yeah. You got up on that stage and you killed it. You were amazing. And I remember just, again, you just shared your heart and you were so vulnerable. And that's what made it so great. Mm-hmm. I remember you did shed some tears, but I really believe that the people in that conference got to hear the truth about fear that you had faced and that you were overcoming in that moment. And I really believe that it did impact their lives. I know I was impacted by it. And I remember having lunch with you that day and talking about it with you. And it was just such a special moment. But I remember that moment. And it was really precious and really beautiful. And you're so amazing that you just do it anyways. You know, you faced that fear. Your husband pushed you to do it. And you did it. You did it anyways, even though you were feeling that intense feeling of fear.
Thank you.
We talk about in our emotional processing that the acronym for fear is the best one that I've heard of is face everything and rise. And that's what you did.
That is so good. I haven't heard that one.
Yes.
I always hear the false evidence appearing real, but that one is real good.
Totally. It caused me to like really dive in. I got to study, and it's my favorite thing to talk on today.
Yes.
Because so many people battle it. Like so many people are battling their fears.
Yeah.
And I want to share the second aha moment that really helped me get over, or really not get over, take that first step.
Right.
Number one, my husband calling me out to speak that I had about a year prior, a mentor called me out too. And it was someone that I really respected. He'd watched my journey. He knew I had opportunities I was running from. And he finally looked me in the eyes and he said, Kim, you're not helping anyone. You're not serving anyone. You're not impacting anyone because you're sitting on your talent. And I was like, number one, I was like, oh, but I don't have any talent. You know,
right.
And then I instantly went to the parable in the Bible of the man that Jesus actually called wicked because he took the talents and hid them in the ground.
Yeah.
Wicked, lazy servant. And I instantly was like, that's me. That's me. And I had that stirring. I was like, I want to impact people. I want to help people. Like helping people is my gift. Mm. But when your fears stop you and prevent you, your fears literally prevent you from your destiny.
Yeah.
They can.
They really
if you don't confront them. Mm. And the beautiful thing is that you have total control over your fears and your thoughts. And you can, in a heartbeat, switch the trajectory of how you think. In a moment, you can just say no.
Right.
And so two things that really helped me with fear. I want to give these resources because it has changed my life. Mm-hmm. Number one was Carolyn Leaf's book, Switch On Your Brain.
Yes.
So good.
Good book.
Totally a good book. She's a Christian neuroscientist. So she mixes faith with science and she can make your brain make sense. But she basically makes you realize that you're in control of your thoughts, not the other way around.
Right. Yes.
So all these thoughts that are on autopilot, you can control those.
Yeah.
And we have ownership over it.
Amen.
Amen. Right. So what I did every day, multiple times a day, sometimes every hour, every minute was when I had that thought, I had to physically speak the word cancel and then speak the opposite. So when I heard, Kim, you're not good enough, cancel, and I would physically say it.
Yeah.
You are good enough. You are worthy. God created you perfectly in his image.
That's
and
so
I would
good.
Speak the opposite. Yes. Yeah. And when you cancel agreements that you've made with words, your thoughts become your words, become your actions, become your destiny. So when you start canceling your thoughts that are negative and don't align with your identity, and then you speak the true identity over you, you literally are changing your brain. Your brain physically changes.
Right.
That's so good because you're actually, by saying cancel, you're bringing awareness to your entire body.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Exactly. It's such a powerful word. It's my favorite word, because when you cancel something, it no longer exists, right?
Right, truly. Exactly.
You have a gym membership, you cancel it, you no longer can access the gym.
Right.
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 Right. And you no longer want to access those thoughts.
Exactly.
Right.
Well, and then the enemy has no access to those thoughts once they're canceled.
Right.
Exactly. It's so powerful because you're taking authority.
Mm.
And God gave us the authority.
Right.
Yes.
Anytime anyone listening and you're struggling with those thoughts, we all do. We all do. But this has got to be a daily thing that you can truly change the way you think and set yourself in the right direction in your true identity and who you really are, and speak those words over your life. It will change your destiny. It will.
Yeah.
So the book, Carolyn Lee, and then the word cancel and being the opposite. So if you don't know like who you truly are, your identity, Google it. Because the Bible, there's so many scriptures. You got to speak the word over your life.
Yeah.
But yeah, that the Bible and Carolyn Lee, period.
That is so good. Oh, I love that mindset hack. I'm going to implement that. And it's really encouraging me to even like pursue some inner healing, maybe with Leslie even, because Leslie is amazing. She's a doctor, obviously, in education, but she's also a inner healing and deliverance minister. And she has lots of amazing friends that are too.
I run with a inner healing and deliverance crowd.
Yes. Yes. And she does
amazing
raindrop therapy too. They release a lot.
Emotional release.
Yeah, emotional release. It's just really inspiring me to go deeper, because I've been wondering too, like, what is holding me back?
Right.
I've seen you overcome it. And I know prior to, you were totally comfortable just being in the background and supporting your husband, which you did with such grace and such diligence. And you did it amazingly. Like, I watched you do it. And your husband is a go-getter. And without you, he wouldn't be where he is today. And, you know, they say behind every good man, there's a good woman. You are just such an amazing wife and mother. And I've seen behind the scenes too. And I see how you handle things and how you diffuse things. And you guys, you have such a beautiful marriage and such a beautiful family. I really believe that it's you holding it all together. Like, Tom's phenomenal, and he obviously has a huge part to play in it too, and he's so fun. Oh my gosh, I love his energy and I love how fun he is. But yeah, you really have held it all together. And like I said, I've seen you overcome that fear though, to go from just being behind the scenes to now you took the lead in a way of entrepreneurship, and you were there by his side the whole time. And now you've kind of flipped roles in some ways. I know you still support him, but you've kind of flipped roles in some ways, and now you've taken the lead in Savvy Fitness Wear.
Yes.
And you're the top earner now, and
crazy.
You lead thousands of women overcoming fear and obstacles. You've created a phenomenal income for your family. We were talking about this before, and you shared that you're doing $4 million in sales as a team.
In a year.
Yeah.
Every month.
Every month.
Within just a year of launching. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. I want to say, you know, fear is never going to go away. It's always going to present itself. And it's the learning how to move through it and, you know, really taking captive of what you are thinking so that you can take that step, although it's scary, take that step. And so about a year ago, I had the opportunity to partner with a company, and everything in me knew I was supposed to do it. Like, I was called to it. Everything in me was so terrified, because all of a sudden the lies came back. You're not good enough. Who's going to follow you? It's amazing how it just comes right back and you have to cancel it. In a moment, I was, what do I do? Do I shrink back like I have for so many years at opportunity, or do I step into this terrifying opportunity to, for the first time? Like, I've always been behind my, and kind of in the shadows, like you said, Jackie, of support, in a supportive role.
Yeah.
You know, while we were having kids, and, you know, that was my comfort zone. My husband's a go-getter. He makes a good mess. And I kind of cleaned it up. And
yes, you do. It's awesome.
And I did that for many years, but that was my comfort zone. And I liked it there. It was comfy and cozy. Mm-hmm. But I felt I was being called out of that for the first time, step into leading. Mm-hmm. And I never really had led in the industry that we're in of network marketing. We've been very successful, but it was more my husband leading and I was the supportive role in the back end.
Right.
So here I was, this opportunity to really lead something for the first time. And I talked to my husband, and like every supportive husband would do, he said, "No way can you do that."
Right. I need you. That was what he was saying though, right? Like, totally. I need you. You can't like divide your attention to anything else because I'm going and I'm moving and I need you in the supportive role that you've always been in.
That's right. I was going to thank you, Jackie. He was like, because at the time we were running our coaching, I had a mom's fitness community I was running. We have our kids, you know, and he's like, "There's no way you can do it." And of course I'm like, he doesn't believe in me, but that's not what he was saying. He was like, physically, there's no way you can do it.
Right.
Right. So he did not support me. It was a no. It was a hard no. And then I went to my tail between my legs. I went to my best friend and I'm like, "Lisa, I'm going to do this. Do this with me." And like every best friend should do, she told me no.
Right.
She told me no. She's like, "I love you, Kim. This is perfect for you." She was the one I'd actually cried on her shoulder because I knew this was, I was being called to it. And she, it's like, "Kim, I believe in you, that you got to do this. You got to do this." So then when I went to her and I was like, "Lisa, let's do this." And she told me, "No, I'm alone. I don't have my husband and I don't have my best friend. And who's going to follow me?" So wow. All of those fears, truly, I almost walked away from it almost. But thank God he had been working on me for a few years on this battle of fear. I took the step. I said, yes. I said, yes. And you know, when you're called, when you're being called, yeah, because there's something powerful God wants to do with your yes.
Amen.
When I said yes, my next person I went to, she said yes, and it changed everything. The next person I went to, yes. And within 1 year, I grew with just a handful of women through God, grew to over 18,000 women. And what we're doing, 4 million a month, we're across the nation. And that is something that I could never have done.
Right.
But God used my yes. And I can't tell you the women's lives. Oh my goodness. I get to partner with a woman, Natalie, who's building clean water wells in Africa right now, saving lives in Africa.
That's
and
amazing.
I have all these opportunities to partner because I say yes in women's lives who are making money through COVID and able to support their families because I said, yes, God wants your yes. He wants to do something with your yes. And so that's why we have to get over our fears and be willing to just take that step, even though it's scary, even if you feel alone, even if you don't feel qualified, say yes.
Say yes. So good.
So good. When you were battling that stage of not having your husband's support and not having your best friend's support and just wondering if you were even supposed to do it or not, I knew that you were supposed to do it. And I just had so much fun with you in that season, just talking with you and brainstorming with you and dreaming with you.
Yes.
I'm so glad that we had those calls and that we got to do that together.
And you prayed with me. You are such a big part of my story, Jackie. I know I wouldn't be here without you and your support and your prayers and your love, truly. So being here right now with you is really amazing.
Thank
for me. And by
you.
The way, to finish that story, within a few months, my husband and my best friend, both, my husband and I actually do this together now. We're having a blast. And my best friend has the biggest business inside of my business. So
you
never know. Like, even if someone says no, it doesn't always mean no.
Right. Yeah. It just means not right now.
Yes. And when your conviction is strong enough, people come around you. And so just know, even if you don't know if you're really supposed to do it, but deep down, like, you do know. You know,
the only
one lying to you is the enemy, who doesn't want you to step into that because he wants to prevent you from what God wants to do through you.
Right.
That when you know, do it, and people will come around that.
Exactly. Amen. That's so good.
So powerful. Okay. So you overcome fear. You become one of the top leaders in the industry through Savvy Fitness. We're going to post a link to Savvy Fitness so you can check it out in the comments. Now, on top of all of that, your family becomes social media celebrities. And I know that your husband had been on social media for years and he had a good following, but we talked about earlier that your daughter made a TikTok video with you being the star as Hot Mom Check, because you are a hot mom.
Beautiful
saying.
Video.
I showed Leslie before we did the before we jumped on with you, and she was just blown away. She's like, oh my gosh, she is gorgeous.
Oh, funny. I get messages all the time from clients who see that video and go, is this you?
That's hilarious. Yes. But my favorite is the company that you and your husband were building a while back,
like 9 years ago.
Yeah, something like that. And this is where I heard about you guys. Yeah. Was the toilet paper company.
Gosh, I love it.
Oh my gosh.
With that toilet paper company.
I don't remember what it was called, but I do know people who need to wipe their butt.
And you guys said that if we know someone that could wipe their butt, we could become billionaires.
Yes.
Billionaires. Such a big movement. Yes. That was the funniest video.
Oh my
gosh. Such a funny moment.
It was, yeah.
I love it.
So Tom and Kim did a funny spoof video with building a home-based business through selling toilet paper. It was hilarious. It's on YouTube. You can find it. But it was so funny, Kim, because when I was telling Leslie about you, she was like,
Is she
the one that did the toilet paper video? And I was like, huh? What do you mean toilet paper video? And she found it on YouTube. And so she said she saw it at one of the conferences that you and I had been to.
But that was funny. And I have to just give a disclaimer. If you do look us up, my husband and I, we love to have fun.
Yes.
We love to just show our family and the silly things we do. And I think our best video by far of this to date is the farting one I did.
No.
Is that the one where Tom threw you up over his shoulders just recently? Or is that a different one?
No, years ago when social media just started, like Facebook just launched, we used Facebook to prank each other.
Oh my goodness.
And I pranked him. He was on a call with a prospect. I literally, that's when we had like phones in the house. And I pick up the phone and I played fart noises from my computer.
Well, he was on the phone with a prospect.
And just, oh my gosh, that's all on YouTube. You could look it up. It's hilarious because they were trying to figure out who did it.
Either you or one of the girls.
Oh, that's great.
So since you guys have become social media celebrities, how do you manage it all? Like, how do you manage this top business that you're leading and then four teenage girls all learning how to drive and with boyfriends all at the same time? You're amazing but crazy fun husband that's constantly still pulling pranks. How do you manage it all? What is your secret? What is your hack for that? I want to know.
Oh my goodness. I wish I had a really good answer for this. Because deep down, it's kind of like, am I really doing this well? You know, you always kind of like, man, you're just kind of holding on for dear life sometimes. And I'll tell you, just through the seasons of life, if this all had happened while my kids were four, under four, it wouldn't have happened, right?
God's perfect timing, right?
So I believe that there's seasons in your life where some seasons are busier than others. And I'm in a great season. My kids are older. I can focus, you know, more on things. But I'll tell you a couple of hacks that really help with managing it all. For me, with my health, before I share that, I want to share, like, if you're a mom and you only have pockets of your day to make things happen, utilize those pockets. Like, it's really intentions. It's your intention.
Right.
And yes, rest. Yes, take care of yourself, you know, but if you have 30 minutes here, there's so much you can do with 30 minutes if you're intentional with that time. And it's a muscle you have to build. You know, when I was working out, my kids were so little and I was homeschooling them. I would give them 20 minutes to read a book and I would do 20 minutes of a workout, you know, right there. So it's just really restructuring your day so that you can be more effective with the time you do have. A hack for me with my health that I was going to share what I mentioned earlier is this concept of intermittent fasting. Awesome. There are days and sometimes weeks I don't work out, but because I intermittent fast, it's a hack with really being able to, you don't change like anything. It doesn't cost you any money. You just restructure how you eat and when.
Right.
So I've been doing that for years where I just skip breakfast and I eat. And if you don't know about intermittent fasting, study it and research it. It's actually really healthy for you. It resets your hormones, your HGH levels. But what it does is allows you, if you do skip a workout or if you're trying to lose weight, it allows your body the time to actually go into a fat burning mode before, you know, most of us, if we do eat breakfast, it puts us back into digestive mode. And then, you know, you have to absorb the food and then we eat again in digestive mode and they have to absorb. So when you give yourself a break from eating, it actually goes into a fat burning mode and a healing mode. So if you have any kind of area your body needs healing, it's able to heal and not work on digesting and absorbing. Does that make sense?
Yes. So I'm nursing a 4-month-old baby. And when you're in postpartum and you're nursing, is that something that you can actually implement?
I would embrace nursing.
Yeah.
And I would, yeah, because you don't want to restrict calories. Your milk source might not be right. So no, I would wait and embrace nursing as long as you nurse. That is a special season in life.
Yes, it's so special.
And I just want to say really quick too, just embrace your postpartum body and just know that it's okay. And God created you this way. And even if you have some fat storage still, I know personally when I nursed, I would not lose my weight until after I stopped nursing.
Yeah.
And I would hold weight, like I would hold fat until I stopped nursing. After I think 2 children, I finally realized that and I started giving myself grace because I was always fit and always very athletic and active. And I would feel so bad about my body and about how clothes fit me. And I was just like, why can't I get rid of this? And then I realized with 3 that it was just because I was nursing and it was okay. And I finally had grace.
Yes. Your body's designed to hold on to fat while in that season because the baby needs that. Super healthy. So yeah, I would embrace that. You guys, your body can absolutely get back into shape. Give it the time it needs to do what it needs to do for your baby.
That's good. Thank you. Yeah, Jackie's been witnessing all of my insecurities this week.
Yeah.
But I just love
beautiful.
You so much. Yes.
And here's going back to the intermittent fasting though. When you are ready, I would intermittent fast. Like for me, I stop eating around 7:30. I'm not real strict. I am not strict. I don't count macros. I don't count calories. I don't do any of that. I stop eating. And then I eat again around 12:30. And at first it might be hard, you know, if you haven't done it, but then your body gets so used to it.
Yeah.
And I actually think better. I have more energy. I just feel better. Now a hack on top of a hack with this is that if you intermittent fast and then you get a little workout in while you're fasted, it's like double time fat burning. So you are in a fat burning mode. And if you do a brisk walk, or you can actually do a workout, you're going to be burning pure fat. All of the energy of your body is going to be going to fat burning. And then as soon as you're done with your workout, go eat. And eat something that I always do, like a balance of healthy carbs, protein, and fat. I love eating fat now. Your body needs fat.
Yes.
If you eat fat, your body will burn fat. So don't not eat fat like I did. Don't do that.
Yes.
Your body needs, God created all of it.
Yes.
We need all of it.
Right.
And another hack I would say, and this is hard if you're a new mommy, a nursing mommy, I get this, but rest is so important. Sleep. I just did a whole hour long podcast on sleep alone.
Wow.
And what happens when we don't sleep, and what happens when we even miss like just a few hours of sleep one night, our immune system drops like 40%. It gets crazy. Our ability to fight off disease.
Goodness.
There's so much that happens when we sleep and when we rest, and we have to somehow, some way get a good 7 to 8 hours of rest in. It will change your life. Our brain cannot retain information if we don't rest. It literally can't. That's why we get brain fog or we start forgetting things. That's why as a new mom, you don't know what day it is, how many kids you have, like you're so sleep deprived.
Oh my goodness.
But it's so important. So a lot of us struggle with sleeping at night.
Yeah.
And so it's so important to train our bodies, even if you just try to get to bed 30 minutes earlier, to get the rest we need. Cause it is, I mean, I wish I could give you all the stats on how important it is. We don't have time, but it is life-changing. It's life-changing, like with your health, with your mental capacity, everything.
Wow.
Just by resting. Those 2 things I just told you, intermittent fasting and rest, cost no money.
Right.
And it will change your life. Well, thank you for having me.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time. This has been really awesome. I've really, really enjoyed hearing your story. It's resonated with me so much. And I know that it resonates with a lot of women. I'm just so proud of you for facing everything and rising and for tackling this thing head on. It's just very inspiring.
Thank you. That means so much. Really, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I do. And I can't wait to meet you in person.
Me
too. I know I've heard so many good things, so many amazing things.
Oh,
and
thank
I wouldn't
you.
Be surprised if we had met sometime through one of our similar backgrounds.
We might have.
I just love you so much, Kim. And I'm so grateful for your time and for all of your expertise and all of your story and just how genuine and authentic you've been with us.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for spending time with us today.
Thank you for being brave, for having your mind and heart open to receive what we've shared.
We pray that it touches you so deeply that you are transformed from the inside out.
If you've loved spending time with us as much as we have with you, we have great news for you.
We have a tribe of other moms just like you that are committed to living life to the fullest and are a source of encouragement, support, and love.
Go to Point of Decision on Facebook now to join our growing tribe.
I'm Dr. Leslie Bayless.
And I'm Jackie Bailey.
We love you.
We're praying for you.
And we are looking forward to spending more time with you on Point of Decision.